Myself, Dr. Sanjay Nag, Assistant Professor, Microbiology Lab, Anuran Ram Medical College. Today I am going to start pneumococci or pneumococcus from systemic bacteriology section of microbiology. Morphologically, it is gram-positive cocci. Its diameter is 1 micrometer and it is slightly elongated. In which one point is broad and other point is pointed. One end is broad or rounded and other is pointed. It looks like it resembles flame cell. It appears in pair in which broad surfaces, broad ends are in opposition and it is surrounded by both cocci, is surrounded by a capsule. So it is gram positive cocci. Length diameter is about 1 micrometer. It is slightly elongated in which one end is broad and other is pointed. It resembles flame cell or lanceolate cell. It presents in pair, so it is diplococci, in which broad ends are in opposition and it is surrounded by a capsule. So it is capsulated diplococci resembling flame cell and lanceolate cell. Culture it is aerobic and facultative anaerobic. Temperature required is 25 to 42 degrees centigrade, but optimal temperature is 37 degrees centigrade. pH required is 7.8. It is aerobic and facultative anaerobic. Temperature range is 25 to 42 degrees centigrade, whereas optimal temperature for bitter growth is 37 degrees centigrade. And pH required for bitter growth is 7.8. It does not grow in ordinary media. Enriched media is required for the culture of pneumococci. When it is inoculated in blood agar media and incubated at 37 degrees centigrade, initially after 80 hours of incubation, it forms dome-shaped colony. When it is inoculated in blood agar at 37 degrees centigrade, initially after 18 hours of incubation, it forms dome-shaped colony, whereas for long incubation, further incubation, this dome-shaped colony flattened, in which edges are raised and there is central ammonation. After 18 hours of incubation, for further incubation for a longer time, up to 24 hours, this dome-shaped colony flattened, in which the edges are raised and there is central ammonation and it looks like caramel point. or drought may appear. So the only resembling carotoid or drossman appearance in blood agar media, when it is inoculated in liquid media like glucose broth, it forms uniform turbidity. When it is inoculated in liquid media like glucose broth, it forms uniform turbidity. So in solid media, it is inoculated in blood agar and it forms carom point appearance and protrusive appearance of the colony. In question at 37 centigrade for more than 18 hours. When it is inoculated in liquid media like glucose broth, it forms uniform turbidity. Now culture, now biochemical reaction. It ferment so many sugars with production of acid, no gas. Fermentation of inulin differentiate pneumococci from streptococci. Pneumococci ferment inulin, whereas streptococci does not ferment inulin. The constant property other biochemical reactions of pneumococci are first bisolubility test. This bisolubility test is a constant test of pneumococci, and the principle of bisolubility test is when pneumococci comes in contact with bile salt or 10% sodium deoxycholate, there is lysis of muriatic acid. There is lysis of bond between muriatic acid and alanine present in peptidoglycan layer of the cell wall of pneumococci. When pneumococci comes in contact with 10% sodium deoxycholate, there is lysis of bond between muriatic acid and alanine present in peptidoglycan layer of cell wall of pneumococci, and pneumococci lysed and it is soluble. So this is the principle of bisolubility test. How this test performed? It can be performed by two methods. First, tube method. For this, take a test tube, and in the test tube, take 1 ml of broth. Culture with pneumococci overnight. In a test tube, take 1 ml of broth culture with pneumococci overnight. And then in this 1 ml of broth, add few drops of 10% sodium deoxycholate. After addition of this 10% sodium deoxycholate to the broth containing pneumococci, this turbid broth becomes clear, and this is due to dissolve of pneumococci in bile salt. Or lysis of pneumococci in bile salt. of breakage of uramic acid and alanine bond in the peptidoglycan layer of the cell wall of the tank. So this is one method. And second method, slide test. In this test, take a slide and take sample on the slide. Take probe on the slide containing pneumococci. Then add bile salt or sodium deoxycholate. After addition of bile salt or sodium deoxycholate on this probe, there is clear no turbidity of broth. And this is due to lysis of the pneumococci or dissolve of the pneumococci in the broth. This test is very easy test, and we can do this test on the bedside of the patient with a sputum. We can do this test at the bedside of the patient with a sputum. Next, antigens. Pneumococci mainly contain capsule. And this capsule is type a specific capsular polysaccharide. This capsule is composed of type specific capsular polysaccharide, and this type specific capsular polysaccharide has tendency to dissolve in media, in float, any type of float, in exudate, and if after dissolve in soluble in this liquid substance, it forms a specific soluble substance. Triple S. Type of specific capsule peptide has tendency to dissolve in the liquid like in media, in exudate, any type of media like in CSF, and it for a specific soluble substance. On the basis of this nature of a specific soluble capsular polysaccharide, this pneumococci is classified into 90 serotypes on the basis of type specific nature of the type specific capsular polysaccharide. Pneumococci is classified into 90 serotypes. Now, how it is classified into different serotypes? First, it is classified into different serotype by agglutination of cocci with a specific antiserum. Second method, serotype classification. Second, precipitation of a specific soluble substance by a specific serum. And third, by Quillen reaction. Quillen reaction classified by Linfield in 1902, and Cooler reaction, to perform Cooler reaction, take a slide, on the slide take a sputum containing any substance containing pneumococcal, and then add antiserum with methylene group. After addition of antiserum and methylene group on this substance containing pneumococci, the capsule swelling and refractile, and this shows that in the presence of antiserum, this capsule swelling, it means it shows that pneumococci is capsulated. And this is the Cooler reaction, and on the basis of Cooler reaction it is classified, not only Cooler reaction but on the basis of precipitation, agglutination and Cooler reaction, it is classified into 90 serotypes. Next antigen is C reactive protein. C-reactive protein. This C-reactive protein is a normal protein, and it is beta-globulin. It is synthesized and released by hepatocytes, and the condition where C-reactive protein is released or synthesized and released, these conditions are, first, infection, inflammation, tissue destruction, and malignancy. So C-reactive protein is abnormal protein, it is beta-globulin, and it is synthesized by hepatocytes, and the condition where the synthesis of C-reactive protein is increased are, first, infection, inflammation, tissue destruction and malignancy. Now pathogenicity. Pneumococci colonizes in the nasopharynx. And from nasopharynx it can directly spread to biliary, paranasal sinuses, and respiratory tract. And through the blood, it may go to meningeal layer, meninges, and causes meningitis. Here, it spread to middle ear, causing otitis media. It has spread to paranasal sinuses, causing sinusitis, and it has spread to respiratory tract, causing lower pneumonia and bronchopneumonia. Patient releases a sputum with large number of pneumococci, suffering from lower pneumonia and bronchopneumonia. It also causes meningitis, and it causes meningitis in all age group. From from nasopharynx through the blood, it goes to meningeal layers, causes meningitis. In this condition, when suffering from meningitis due to pneumococcus, this meningitis caused by pneumococcus, it can affect all age group, and in this condition, last number of pneumococci can be present in CSF and other sorbate substance also present in CSF caused by meningitis caused by pneumococci are specific sorbate substance. So these are the diseases specificity caused by pneumococci. It also causes suppurative lesions and suppurative lesions may be conjunctivitis, pericarditis, arthritis, this pericarditis occurs after bacteremia due to pneumococci. When it is spread from nasopharynx to meningeal layer or central nervous system through the blood, here it causes pericarditis. Next, leptospirosis. For lab diagnosis, sample collection is the most important. For diagnosis of pneumococci, if patient is suffering from respiratory tract infection or nasopharynx infection, a sputum is taken. If patient is suffering from meningitis, in this condition, central spinal fluid is taken, cerebral spinal fluid is taken. If patient develops blood bacteremia, in this condition, blood is taken for blood culture, and lastly, urine can be taken because some patient passes antigen of pneumococci through their urine. First, sputum, second, CSF, then blood, and then urine. Next diagnosis method is microscopical examination. Microscopical examination. For microscopical examination, take sample from the patient. If patient is suffering from lower pneumonia, bronchopneumonia, and patient realizes a sputum contains large number of pneumococci, in this condition, take a sputum, make a smear, and do gram staining. After gram staining, you will find that it is gram positive cocci arranged in a pair surrounded by capsule resembling lanceolate shape or flip shape. So this is the microscopic examination. Take sample from the patient, make a smear on slide and do gram staining. After gram staining, observe under microscope and you will find gram-positive cocci present in pair, where one end is pointed, other end rounded or broad, resembling present in the pair. One end is broad, other is pointed, and it is surrounded by capsule resembling lanceolate shape. So after microscopical examination, you will find lanceolate shape diplococci in the smear, gram positive cocci in the smear. Next, culture. Sample is inoculated in blood agar media. Blood agar media and incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. After 24 hours, you will find colony, and this colony looks like carom point appearance or drought spots appearance. Carom point appearance or drought spots appearance. Initially, after incubation for 18 hours, it developed dome-shaped colony. Further incubation at 37 degrees centigrade, the dome-shaped colony flattened, where margin rest and there is central composition, and it looks like carom point appearance or drought spots appearance. Clear? By chemical reactions, it ferments so many sugars, it ferments inulin, and inulin fermentation differentiates pneumococci from the streptococci. It is bile soluble and it is sensitive to optochin. To perform optochin test, take blood agar media, and in this blood agar media, a filter paper impregnated with ethyl hydrocuprine is kept. Take a blood agar media, or in the blood agar media, a filter paper impregnated with ethyl hydrocuprine is kept, and then inoculate pneumococci and incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. After 24 hours of incubation at 37 degrees centigrade, we will find there is no growth of colony around the ethyl hydrocuprine disc, and this shows pneumococci is sensitive to ethyl hydrocuprine, and this is known as optochin test. So it is sensitive to optochin. There is no development of colony around the disc containing hydrocuprine. So it is sensitive to optochin. Next diagnosis, by inoculation of pneumococci in experimental animal, and this test is done where microscopy will be negative and culture will be negative, where a scanty or very less amount of culture colony develops. So in this condition, if there is a scanty pneumococci present in the sample, in this condition, it is inoculated in the experimental animal like mouse. It is inoculated intraperitoneal to the experimental animal, and after inoculation intraperitoneal in the experimental animal, this experimental animal will die within 1 to 3 days. After death of the experimental animal, we can take exudate from the peritoneum. And then do microscopical examination and culture from the exudate. You will find gram-positive cocci lanceolate shape or flame shape after microscopical examination, and you will find carom point appearance of the colony after culture in blood agar media. So this test is done where there is a scanty pneumococci present in the sample. Next diagnosis, by blood then development of bacteremia. Initially, it colonizes into nasopharynx, and from the nasopharynx, it spread. It goes to central nervous system, affecting meninges, and it goes to central nervous system by the blood, and here it develops bacteremia. In this condition, we can do blood culture for detection of pneumococci. So next, blood culture. Next, detection of a specific soluble substance. As I told previously, most important antigen structure of pneumococci is capsule, and capsule is type a specific capsular polysaccharide, and it has tendency to dissolve in the liquid substances, even in the culture media, in urine, in body fluids. So after dissolve, it forms a specific soluble substance. So if meningitis suffering from meningitis caused by pneumococci, the capsule polysaccharide dissolves in the central nervous system, cerebrospinal fluid, and it forms a specific soluble substance. And detection of the specific soluble substance from the liquid from the cerebrospinal fluid of the patient suffering from meningitis diagnoses the pneumococci. Next, diagnosis is done by CRP, C-reactive protein. In pneumococcal infection, this C-reactive protein increased, and C-reactive protein is abnormal protein. It is beta globulin, and it is synthesized and released by hepatocytes. There are some conditions where C-reactive protein increased are first infection, inflammation, tissue destruction, and malignancy. In pneumococcal infection, C-reactive protein is highly increased. But after treatment, this C-reactive protein is going to decrease. So it is marker of prognosis of the patient of pneumococci. So these are the method for the diagnosis of pneumococci. Thanks. That's all for today.